In this video, we're going to look at an app called Explain Everything for the iPad. It is available in the Apple App Store for $2.99. It is a really remarkable app that allows you to create really high-level lecture captures, tutorials, and whiteboard activities on your iPad. So when you launch Explain Everything, to get started, in the upper left-hand corner are the plus signs. The first plus sign are some color templates. This is version 2 of Explain Everything. So in version 2, you get some of these template-based creation options. The next plus sign allows you to import from your photo library, from Dropbox, from Evernote, Google Drive, or Box. And this is really powerful because you could build a presentation in PowerPoint or Keynote, save it as a PDF, and import it into Explain Everything to annotate over the top of and record on. In this example, I'm just going to grab some photos from my camera roll here on my iPad. Click Done, and it will import my photos into a new project. Because I selected two photos, it automatically breaks them into two slides. This is the same effect when you import a PowerPoint or Keynote. I would recommend saving it as a PDF and then import from your Box or Dropbox account into Explain Everything, and it will break it up so each slide has its own page to annotate on. The first tool in the upper left-hand corner is the finger tool. This allows you to move your objects around. You can resize them by pinching them together and using the gestures on the iPad. The next icon, which is this page with a plus sign, when I click on it, it adds a blank page on my presentation, which is really good in when you're working in a presentation and recording, say, your lectures in a classroom, because you can, on the fly, grab a new page and, say, work a math problem. To do annotations, you need the pencil tool. And as the third one down here, I can click and hold on it and change the size and the width of the pencil. And then if I go down to the bottom left, I can click and hold on the color, and I can change the color of my pencil. So right now it's black, but I can change it to green. And then I go anywhere on my screen and I start annotating. Again, when we get down to the bottom, I'll show you the record feature so you can record your voice with your annotations. Working down again on the left is the shapes tool. When I click on it and hold down, I can pick various shapes. So I can draw an arrow on my screen. And then with my tool at the top left, my finger tool, I can move it around, sort it, change it. So again, this is my finger tool, add a page, my annotation pencil tool, and I'm on shapes right now. Next up are the text. If I click on it, I can click on the screen, and I can start typing. If I click and hold down on the text button, I can change the font and the font size, and I can actually add a border to my text box. So again, I can go to my screen, click, and type with my iPad keyboard. You can move it, center it any way you would like, normal sort of word processing features. If I'm happy, I click the checkbox. And again, it makes it an object so I can move it around my page anywhere. The next item is sort of to add objects on a fly. So if I wanted to add another picture, a video, or something from somewhere else on my iPad or in my Dropbox or Box accounts, I can pull it right in with that button on the fly. This is a great feature, so if you wanted to use Explain Everything to create your presentation, really build it from the ground up, as opposed to importing a PowerPoint or a previously created presentation, this is a great way to do that. And I think with version 2 of Explain Everything, which I'm showing here, they've done a great job to make this a really powerful presentation software that would be realistic to build your own presentations right through here. Next up is the X, and this allows you to delete an object. If I click on it, after clicking the X and hit the red X, it will delete that object. To delete that or to not delete something, you just click away from it. So I'm going to go back to my finger. Again, that's the delete. This is a really cool tool for professors and teachers. This is the laser pointer tool. If I click on it, I now have a laser pointer. So if I'm in a lecture hall and my iPad's connected to an Apple TV and a projector or through VGA to a projector, I no longer have to have a laser pointer. I can just use present right from my iPad and point things out with this laser icon. If I click and hold down on it, there are some different options for the laser pointer, like an arrow. The next tool is the layering tool. For this tool, I'm going to create another shape to demonstrate the layering. So I'm going to click and hold down. I'm going to create a square this time. Make the border really thick. If I want to change the color of my shape, I just click and hold down. I'll make it yellow. And then I just draw my shape. If I wanted to layer my shapes right now, because this is the latest object I've added, so it's automatically on the top. But let's say I wanted to add type to the top of this object. That's where this tool right here, the dotted square and the eye, comes in really handy. If I click on it and then click the object I want to move, I'll bring it to the front, and now it's on top of my box. So this is just like a lot of different whiteboard software. This allows you to lock things in place so they won't move anymore. It allows you to do a lot of layering object sort of things, and it's really powerful and a brand new addition to this version of Explain Everything. Next up is the undo button, which allows you to undo your last move, and it actually goes back a little bit farther. So that's a really handy tool to undo an error you may have made. Next up is a really cool magnifying tool that allows you to really get infinite space inside your presentations. So I'm going to go to a new slide. This one has an image I had added before, but let's pretend I was working a math problem here, and I'll do a really advanced math problem. Now let me change my color here so it's a little bit darker. And I'm working this really advanced math problem, and I'm bringing down and I run out of space, let's say, but I want to keep going and I'm capturing my voice here. I can click on this magnifying glass with the plus sign, pinch together with my gestures on my iPad, move it to the corner up here, go back to my pen, and start working the problem again. This is extremely powerful, and it's similar to what you can do in Prezi, where you have infinite space available to you as a presenter. I can zoom in also, and I can also zoom out. So really, it opens up the ability to do some really advanced things on your slides and not have to worry about, if you're working, again, in this example, a math problem, running out of space. I'm just going to grab a shape again so I can point out some of the features. So I'll just build a arrow really quick, spin it around. And I'm just using my iPad and sort of both two fingers moving these around and spinning objects. It's all click touch because it's an iPad app. Really easy, really user-friendly. So next up is this icon here. If I click on it, all this does is it gives me sort of just my basic presentation tools. So if I was pulled in my presentation or created it in Explain Everything, and I didn't want to have all of this area around my presentation with this gray box, I can minimize it and then start working my presentation, changing slides with the arrows, and so on. It just declutters your screen when you're in presentation mode. So now I'm going to skip down to the bottom down here, and this is sort of the running list of your slides that you have available. If I click on it, I can actually reorder my slides by clicking, holding down on the slide, and I just drag and drop, and it allows me to reorder my slides in a different order. The arrows on either side are just forward and back, and so I can change my slides that way. The real powerful tool here is the recording feature, which is located right down here at the bottom. This is really amazing and takes this app to the whole nother level to allow professors and teachers to lecture capture directly from the iPad, which is an extremely powerful thing. So if I click the red button, it is now recording everything I'm doing on the screen. So I can start working some annotations or problems and annotating over my slides. It is capturing everything I'm doing and saying inside of this slide. If I change slides, It will record now everything happening on this slide. I would recommend, sort of a tip, is to pause between slides. Because Explain Everything captures everything on the individual slide, if you talk over when it's transitioning, there will be a break, a little digital glitch, if you will, when you make your recordings. So it's better to pause when you hit this arrow button to go forward, and then start talking on top of your lectures. To stop a recording, you just hit the pause sign. And if I go over here to the right, these are sort of your save and export features. So if I was using this in a meeting just as a whiteboard, again, connected to, say, a projector, if I click on it, I can actually save everything that happened on the slide, not the audio, but just visually, the annotations, right to my camera roll. So if I click on it, it says my image was saved to camera roll. Now if I go back to my photos, you can see right there is a JPEG of everything that happened on my screen when I was on the whiteboard in Explain Everything. So that's really great for note takings or just sort of basic problem working, so that your students would just have a snapshot of what's happening there. Now if you're using this to capture a lecture or work a tutorial, the next one is this film icon. If I click on that, this is where you can actually export everything you've done, either directly to YouTube, to your camera roll, or any of your accounts, again, like Dropbox, Evernote, Google Drive, or Box. You can export as an MP4 everything that happened on your presentation in Explain Everything. This is really powerful, again, because professors or teachers could capture an entire lesson right in here and Explain Everything. Now, a tip on this would also to be to break up your recordings maybe into 15 to 20 minute segments, because then it's more of a workable file. It's not quite as big, and students probably don't want to watch a 90 minute lecture. This is your save button. If I click on it, I can title my project and click save, and it will save this as a project back to my home screen. And then the last button is the home screen. And you can see Title 2 is what I just saved this as. Also notice that it last autosaved Project O is when I jumped out to my camera roll, it did autosave my project. So I find Explain Everything to be an extremely powerful app. It is probably my personal favorite. If you click the I in the upper hand, right-hand corner, you do get some tutorials, some information, provide some feedback directly to Explain Everything, and this is version 2 that just came out in 2013. The icon to the left of that are some settings, so you can change where you want it to export as far as the quality. You can set up some recording features, again, sort of the camera size and resolution, and then you can link all of your accounts, whatever you have, so that you could directly export or post to Box, Dropbox, Drive, wherever you wanted to put it, Twitter, and it'll be right there. So thank you, and enjoy Explain Everything.